Yusuf Nsibambi is defiant and insists he's still the Kampala District land boss, even though he was shut out today. Nsibambi claims that is why he was forced to chair a board meeting elsewhere, although he said taking control of the board's office did not mean dissolving it.
We are not informed. We also don't believe that it is true. However, this morning I passed by. I saw two policemen seated at the door. It was open. An indication that we broke into the office. From here, we're going to contact the police so that we get a briefing why police broke into our office.
Indeed, when we had taken our position to take pictures, a plainclothes security officer shoved us away, telling us no one was supposed to be there, while ordering us back to the KCCA publicist Peter Kauju
to secure that area until investigations are done. So I'm sure after they are done with all that, they will communicate about a clear way forward as Uganda Police.
So what does the police say?
And the investigations are on. A number of people have made statements. But yesterday, just to further these investigations, the officers of Kampala District Land Board were cordoned off, because we feel there are important documents therein which can be vital in the investigations.
In the meantime, Yusuf Nsibambi will have to conduct the land business elsewhere as the battle of egos and control of the city continues.